This is a quite a huge campaign. Its purpose is to create conditions that enhance the implementation of our development plans. You know, we've been crafting and selling and telling you how much we have completed the Retropolis plan, how then we have stimulated the interest of investors in our city, which is no longer any debate now. The biggest challenge we have is to make now this city a friendly environment for investment. In other words, you know, we are from 9 cities into a single one. So Boksburg, Benoni, Kempton Park, Edenvale, they actually constitute the center. So what we're doing is that we are dealing with all the buildings that are abandoned, that are occupied illegally, those are in derelict and left unattended to, those are with criminal people, vagrants, and all of them, those that are left in disuse, so that the city takes its own initiative and assume responsibility to lift its face. That's all this is about. Because we want to make sure that every special space that we have is used for a productive purpose. We don't have a lot of land in Ekurhuleni, for instance. No less than 50 is Tolomatic. So every piece of land we have, we want it to be used for human enhancement in a more productive way. We've got roughly about 30 buildings in Ekurhuleni that are targeted, but so far we've been given permission just to deal with 11 buildings. A set of plans is going to come for all of them. I wouldn't give you the exact plan on this one, but a set of plan in terms of what exactly is going to happen. And that plan will involve phasing in private sector and the city actually putting in particular infrastructure sort of stuff for particular service delivery sort of purpose. You know, as government, they say you act, you are wrong. You don't act, you are wrong. But there's something that you must do. In our view, the cost-benefit analysis of this place, even in medium and long term, is going to benefit the people of Ekurhuleni, including them. Now, you've got a choice to find to make a decision around those two issues. The people there who are capable of looking after themselves know that they are illegally here. They are not supposed to be here. But those who are disabled or old people, there is an attempt by the municipality to check how can they be assisted. Even especially the old age ones, we think those some attempts should be made to incorporate them to old age homes. Those who are capable, like myself and so on, they do understand this is not a place to be. And if I can tell you how many similar places like this, which are constituting risk and creating crime conditions, the impact it has on development, even they themselves and their children, in a long term, there's nothing they're going to benefit. Otherwise, it's not our intention just to put them in the situation they are. But the bigger picture dictates that we have to act in this situation.